Welcome to Analytics with Nags.
In this session, we are going to see about what is for loop container in SSIS. So basically, it is again a looping concept. The for each loop container, which evaluates whatever contents inside a container. It can be file enumerator or it can be ADO enumerator. But what about this for loop container? This looping concept is similar to other programming languages, like you have an initialization and conditional check, then increment for that variable, and again at the end of the loop it will check that condition. If it's success, it will loop through again. So that concept it will be followed. Let us try to check in which scenarios you will use it in SSIS. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the notification. We are in SSIS now, and that scenario, it can be used in a multiple scenario. For simple understanding, let us try to load this file. Okay, we need to load three files, like the 1, 2, 3. So how we need to programmatically do is, like, when the counter is 1, it should get this value, the cust underscore 20 21 010, then the counter value should be assigned here. Then it will check whether, I mean, we need to load three files, right? So 1 is greater than 3, no, then it will go to next file. Next, the counter will be increased. Then 2 is greater than 3, no, so it will go to next file. So 3 is greater than 3, no. Then 4 is greater than 3, yes, it will stop. So basically you need to increment one by one, and you need to start with the one value initialization. Then each time you need to check the condition. You need to set the maximum limit, right? In for each loop container, you no need to set any maximum limit. Whatever the filter criteria that matches that text star dot XLS or CSV with some customization, that follows all the files it will read. But here in for loop container, you need to set some limit, like 1 to 3 files, 1 to 4 files, something like that. In this case, we will try to read these three files alone, how we can do it programmatically. So as I said before, we need to get this file path till this place. Okay, then this value should be incrementally done by a variable. Let us try to do that one. So let us have a for loop container, and as I said before, to store the path till this particular folder along with this particular 00, then we will use this particular, we will store that particular value in a variable. So let us try to create a variable here. This is a new variable I'm going to keep, so it's file path. Okay, file path, it's a string data type, and let us store that value here. D is not valid for a single, what it says, it's not a single. Actually, I need to choose string. That's my mistake. That's okay, fine. Now we need to get the counter. So each counter you need to increment, right? So CNT, and let it start from 1. Okay, now what you need to do, so let us configure the for loop task. So the at CNT, so variable is nothing but your you need to define, you need to refer that variable, the CNT, whatever you created, using at symbol. So at CNT is less than or equal to 3. Okay, and what you need to do at the end of the loop, once this loop is completed, what it should happen, well, less than or equal to 3, it's nothing but we usually increment this count by 1. It can be anything, you can increment by 2 and 1. So basically now what this does, so at the beginning of the loop it will assign one value, that is starting, that is when it is started. Then it will check at the beginning, 1 is less than or equal to 3. Yes, then whatever you define inside this loop, for loop container, that will be evaluated. It can be a simple data flow task, it can be a sending email, whatever. Okay, then the first condition is true, and then at the end, after completing all the tasks, then at the end it will check, it will increment the value. Okay, it will increment, now the value will be 2. Then 2 is less than or equal to 3, right? Now again it is true, then once again it will do the task. That's third time it, when it checks the 3, and at the end of second loop it will increment value 1 to 3. 3 is less than or equal to 3, yes it is true again. Next time, after loading 3 files, it will increment the value by 4. 4 is less than or equal to 3. It is false. So it will come out. So that is the logic, right? So we are getting 1, 2, 3 in this counter. So this value, this count, should be added to this particular string, and then .txt. This is the logic we need to write. And that particular variable, we will give it for this file name, right? So let us try to create another variable. This is complete path, then choose a string. We need to write expression. So now we are writing expression for the variable itself, right? So here the file path, and then for concatenation you can add a plus symbol here. Then what you need to see here is, you are getting this variable, right? When you choose this one, it will prompt you error, because this is a string and this is an integer. You see here, the cnt is integer, this is a string. So you need to typecast here. So typecast to wstr, let's say it's going to have anyway one value, let's give 2 or some value. Now you can see, along with this 0, you are getting 1 here, because cnt value is 1. Now after this, you need to add the extension. So you are dynamically generating, I have added dot txt, okay, you are dynamically generating the file name here. You can see 1.txt. okay, let's click on OK. Now so basically the complete path, you need to give it as a parameter here, so whichever file it loops through, it will have the value. So that particular variable you need to use in your this particular what I'm saying is, the inside your path, that is the main agenda. Like whatever incremental value that is used somewhere in your process in the loop task, then at the end of the loop the value incremental, what process to be followed, you need to write it here. So let us try to have the data flow task. I will copy it from here, I already created, I don't want to waste your time. So let us move here and then go here. It's a flat file, and it's like a customer loop, that is in 15 we have customer loop, which one I copied. Let us try to check the formula here. User path 1, it's not the one. Complete path, so we need to choose customer for loop only. So customer for loop, okay, let's try to get that name. And here in the derived column, that is for the path. I hope you remember why we had a path here. So let us try to have the derived column once again, that is to get the complete path name. And where it is, derived column, let's add it, let's go here, and we are going to get that complete path here. Let's store it as a file path. There you go. Let's try to map it. There is some issue since I copied and pasted. That's okay, delete from here. Now we are done. Now basically what we are going to do, let's see what is the error. Oh, it went, I didn't press OK at that time. Let's do it again. At cnt equal to 1, at cnt less than or equal to 3, and at cnt equal, at cnt plus 1, that's it. Okay, this is absolutely fine now. You can see it is fully completed. Let's not have this one over here that is creating a confusion that when I copy and pasted that has got over here. Let me try to choose this info now. That's it. Okay, now we are going to load only these three files, okay, that is happening programmatically using for loop container as we have filtered 1, 2, 3. Just running it. 1, 2, 3. Let us try to see it here. 1, 2, 3. There is no more files. That's absolutely fine. Let us cross verify it. We don't have data here. Now we can see 1, 2, but there is no file path. Let us see what is the issue. Complete path, since I hope we didn't map it here, that path is not loaded. Yes, so file path, let's click okay. Let's run it again. So we have got the data already, these 9 records. Now again another 9 records will come. Now you can see this data has came from second file. This has come from first file. These records came from third file. That is, we all whichever file path name having value, that is we have run second time. So this is how you can programmatically manage your for loop task. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.